at the second part of St. Thomas Parish Church area. Just the roadway to Portvale Sugar Factory. So this is St. Thomas Parish Anglican Episcopal Church that dates back to 1836. And this area is known as Arch Hall in St. Thomas. Yeah. And again, this is another busy road there now, because it is leading to the north of the island. And it is a highway now. So this is St. Thomas Parish Church here. Years ago, before this, wherever it was a highway, it was just cane ground with no roundabout, just a four cross. So this part of St. Thomas is in close proximity to the north of the island and the west, more city west. St. Thomas is in close proximity to the western side of the island. The port town is in St. James. Sea View and Lasses all in St. James as well. Thomas Parish Church here again. This is a part of the Ronald Mapp Highway, which is also referred as Highway 2A. Ronald Mapp Highway, it can be referred as Highway 2A or the Ronald Mapp Highway. It was renamed the Ronald Mapp Highway in the 90s, after the highway got rebuilt, starting from Warrens, down by Simpson Motors, all the way to Mile and a Quarter in St. Peter, which is to the north of the island. Alright. So this is the artery that turns, that is now used, what it was used to get to the north or west of the island. I happen to use the West Coast Road, which is known as the real one. This is the fastest route to the north or west of the island, because the West Coast is often filled with traffic and the many buses and the frequent stopping of the buses and so on. So many people prefer to use West Coast, I mean, use the highway to put them there faster. That's the rear and cross proximity to the dump, which is known as the mangrove landfill, and the stench comes all the way up here. It has a strong scent, you can smell it from all up here, you can smell the dump at mangrove landfill, all the way up there. So ahead of me now is the one of the largest roundabouts on the island, known as the Lawrence Johnson roundabout. After a member of parliament, Lawrence Johnson, and the roundabout, as I said before, it is the largest roundabout on the island. The left turn at the roundabout will lead you back to Fort Town in St. James, which is on the west coast. Straight ahead will lead you, and it will lead you back to Lassers and Seaview in St. James as well. Still ahead will lead you back to the north of the island via Lancaster in St. James and Westmoreland, also in St. James, and it will lead you back to the Portvale Sugar Factory, which is the only working sugar factory in Barbados. And it will lead you back to the north of the island in the parishes of St. Peter and St. Lucy, the two northernmost parishes on the island. And the right turn will lead you back further east into St. Thomas with the Rock Hall Freedom Village. Rock Hall was the first freedom village in Barbados, where the slaves settled after slavery in 1838. The slaves settled, in Rock Hall in St. Thomas. It will also lead you back to Content and back to Harrison's Cave and Welsh Mahogany and Dukes and Vaughan, all in the parish of St. Thomas.
Wait till it doesn't come back. Bye. Bye.
Yeah, Ross.
Thank you.
lady up here harassing me. Watching out, I have a recipe.